Stereochemistry is the aspect of molecular structure that describes how atoms are arranged in three-dimensional space. This goes beyond the simple bonding connectivity idea, and I thought that I would illustrate where we're heading in our study of stereochemistry with the problem that you see on this page, asking how many different kinds of carbon atoms are in 3-methylvalene, and how many different kinds of carbon atoms are in valine. Now, what you will learn if you look at the answer is that there's nothing surprising about 3-methylvalene, and the bottom line is that those three methyl groups in 3-methylvalene are equivalent to one another. But in the case of valine, you're going to learn that those methyl groups are not the same. Even though they have the same bonding connectivity, they are something about their stereochemical environment that makes them different, and we'll eventually learn that. But before we get to that, we need to reintroduce and remind ourselves some important terms. And the most important question that we're going to ask ourselves dealing with stereochemistry and a comparison between two different molecular structures or between two different groups within a single molecule is, are they the same or not the same? And so isomers are structures that have the exact same number of different kinds of atoms, so C3H8O on the left and C3H8O on the right, same number of carbons, same number of hydrogens, same number of oxygens, but we can very easily recognize them as different. In this case, their difference has to do with how the atoms are connected together. A primary versus a secondary hydroxyl group clearly makes these different kinds of molecules. So the same or not the same? Well, they're clearly not the same. They differ according to bonding connectivity. Those kind of isomers are known as constitutional isomers. What about the next question? Here we see two different carboxylic acids, and we ask ourselves, are these the same or not the same? And the answer is, upon close inspection, is that they're actually the exact same molecule that is just represented in two different ways. In one way, we start from the carboxylic acid on the left and go up and then down, and then in the structure on the right, we start with the carboxylic acid on the left and we draw the first zigzag down and then we go up. And if you were to make a model, and actually this is a reminder that in this subject, the very best thing you can do is to make a model. If I were to show you that presentation, you should be drawing that presentation that's on the left. And then if I were to rotate, say, 180 degrees like that, now I'm showing the presentation that's on the right. Or I could have rotated about an axis that comes down this way, and so if I flip the molecule around like that, I'm back to the beginning. And so just simply by translating or rotating, if the molecule can superimpose on itself, those are known as homomers, and that's exactly what we can do in this case here. Stereoisomers are structures that have identical constitution, but they differ according to the spatial arrangement of the atoms. I can't just superimpose by a translation or by a rotation, as I did in the preceding example. And so here's a couple of cases which we'll look at. In this first case, if I were to take the molecule on the right and try to superimpose it by doing a translation, so let's just take this box and move it over, well, you would discover that once again we've got some problem with the way that the zigzag part of the backbone goes. Notice that we've got the zigzag pointing up in the first three carbon atoms for the structure on the left, while the zigzag points down for the structure on the right. So how are they related to one another? Well, they can't be superimposed. I can't just translate that structure on the right onto the structure on the left. I can't rotate it like I did with the previous structure and superimpose them, but they are related. They're related by a reflection plane. The reflection plane takes every atom on the left-hand side, translates it through that reflection plane, and finds an equivalent atom on the right-hand side. So the carboxylic acid groups, the hydroxyl groups, every carbon in the backbone, including these carboxylic acid groups, are translated through that plane by an equidistant and finds an exact partner on the right-hand side. Molecules which can't be superimposed on one another, but which are mirror images of one another, are known as enantiomers. And in the case of an enantiomer, every stereocenter has changed its configuration. every R became S. And so that's one way that we can recognize molecules that are enantiomers. What about in the case on the bottom? In the case on the bottom, we can see that one of the stereocenters differs from the other one. I almost could take this molecule and translate it and superimpose it by that translation onto the molecule that's on the left, except for the atom that's shown here, where that hydroxyl group has an inverted configuration. So how are these related? Well, these are related as diastereomers. If some, but not all, of the configurations have inverted. So this configuration stays the same, but one of these configurations have inverted, then those are diastereomers. Diastereomers are non-mirror image, so they're not related as a mirror image, and they're not superimposable, so they're stereoisomers.